Here. What? Hunter!
While I'm holding on to my daydream, smoking on some OG, while I'm homegrown and I'm leaning on to my love. My love.
Looks like my old setups. This is so cute. Welcome back to our channel. So if you can't tell, I am starting off today's vlog with a little misguided haul. It's been a hot minute since I've gotten some things from them, but I picked out some really cute dresses for springtime. They would work for like Easter. I think this will go up before Easter. Wedding, guest dresses, vacation, like, you know, cute. And then just some obviously simple everyday wear pieces, including this little tank. Okay, so if I have, I'll put discount code information in the description box down below if it applies. And yeah, all the sizing will be down there and everything. Okay, so first item is this little guy right here. Really cute, just simple little crop white tank. Sorry, my tag's sticking out, with a little lace border. I'm just wearing it with a strapless bra. So cute, just with jeans. I have on Doc Martens and really cute, just easy tank for spring and summer. Love this guy, oh my gosh. I wore this in a recent Instagram photo and it is so cute. It's like a knit brown long sleeve top. Now, the neck is a little bit narrow, so I'm not gonna slip it on because I don't wanna mess up my makeup, but I would definitely put it on before you do your makeup because the neck hole is like a little bit tight on it, but it is so cute. And I feel like it's super like thick and looks like designer. I don't know. This is like one of my favorite misguided finds ever. The material is really nice. Comes with like matching pants too, but I just love the top to wear on its own. Sometimes knit pants cannot be so forgiving, if you know what I mean. This little white cardi, this is so cute and springy. It's got some little details here and a little like ruffle at the bottom, which is so cute. It's not like a ruffle, it's kind of like an elastic. I just threw it on over that tank. Obviously you could just wear it with like a nude bra, but really cute just with jeans or jean shorts. And I really love this material layered over like leather because it's really like girly and like sweet and innocent, and then with like a leather jacket, it's like such a cool combo. Or, you know, Doc Martens with this, like the soft with the grungy. I always love that contrast. So really cute little one. You could also wear this with skirts and stuff like that. This top is so pretty. It is kind of a half crop. It's not completely cropped, obviously, as you can see. You could like tuck it into your jeans if you wanted. But it's like a little mock neck with a little side slit, sweater, beige material. Really cute, easy little top for jeans for springtime. So I definitely feel like I have a lot of basic tops, but when it comes to like, especially now living in Nashville, I feel like I go out to eat a lot more or like go meet someone for a drink. I need like cute little tops that are, you know, just have something going on that I can throw on with jeans and a pair of booties and just instantly have a cute outfit. Now, I know this is not super springy, but I've had my eye on this jacket for a while and I'm pretty sure it just like kept going out of stock in the size that I wanted. So I got a US size 6 because I like my stuff a little bit oversized, but I still like spring goes kind of up and down for like cold and warm weather. So what I envision wearing this with is like a white crop top and like white denim shorts, like an all white look basically, but just like the coat is kind of the piece to keep you warm. So you could even do like a white bralette and white high-waisted shorts with like sneakers or something, or like loafers, and then the jacket is just kind of like that one like big over piece. I just have always really liked the material of this jacket. It's like a, you know, faux leather with the fuzzy stuff, and it's just really cool. It's kind of like a twist on your traditional moto leather jacket, and I love the fuzzy material. I just feel like it makes it feel a little bit springy. So you could definitely style this like for winter and colder weather, but it's just really cute to style it in a spring way, I guess. All right, next are these jeans, and I'm really into the side split jeans for this season. I feel like they're really like coming in, and I really like this pair because they're nice and like fitted and slim. nice and high-waisted. They fit really, really well. And then they've got that really big fun split on the side. They also are a really nice blue denim color that actually looks kind of like a vintage denim, kind of expensive, which is really cute. And I love to wear it with a little booty, splits out the side, and it's so cute. So this is that little top from earlier. You could also like crop it up if you wanted. Really cute. Next is a little comfy item. It's this oversized fuzzy hoodie and two-tone. Really cute. It's already oversized. So this is a size 4 and this is how it fits. It goes right over the butt and actually has this little band, which I normally wouldn't like, but actually kind of sits perfectly over biker shorts. And then just with some sneakers, it's so cute. I always am like looking to grab cute little hoodies that look a little bit more pulled together for, you know, at leisure when you don't want to feel totally like a bum, or, you know, you just want to feel a little bit more dressed up. So I love the sage and the white for spring. I think it's really cute. Another really easy, comfy item is this oversized crew neck in the perfect nude beige color. Now, I'm wearing a size 2 in this, and it is literally the perfect length. It basically, I can wear it as like a little dress with like boots or sneakers just like this. But if you're a little bit taller, I'm 5'2", maybe just throw biker shorts under it, and then it would be like the perfect biker short crew neck to throw over stuff. It's kind of like, it's fuzzy on the inside, but it's kind of thin, so really nice for spring, and the color is just killer. You always need that beige little crew neck throw over to have for springtime. So really cute. You could also wear this over leggings or like activewear. And then this top I actually picked out from the plus size section. This is a plus size 12, I believe. So for me, since I'm a little bit more on the petite side for my frame, this actually fits a little bit boxy, which is perfect. It's kind of how I wanted it. And it's so cute. I mean, honestly, I just have that other little tank layered underneath with a pair of biker shorts and sneakers. Like, it's really cute, and it kind of just like dips down a little bit. But you could also just use this as a top with denim shorts or leather pants. I love knits with leather. I think that's so cute together. So, okay, so this is totally out of my box, and normally I would not go for so much color, but I am on the hunt for an Easter dress. And for some reason, the colors in this dress and the fit just felt really elevated to me, and I really liked the kind of the magenta colors. Sometimes floral patterns can be like a little bit boring, but I just really liked this one. Little cutout at the top on the back with a tie and A-line. It's really flattering. I'm wearing a size 2, and just with a little strappy heel, I feel like for Easter, this is perfect, or just a perfect little spring dress. All right, next is this little blue number, which I love. And again, the blue color just really caught me. I really love the fit of this. I just feel like it's so flattering. It's got the tulle, it's ruched. I probably like need to eat one less bagel before I wear this, but the color is just that really beautiful pastel. Looks like, oh, just so nice on the neck and everywhere. It's so pretty. I don't know, there's something about it that I really, really like, and the blue color is stunning, like with a tan. This could be like a vacay night dress. I don't know, I love it. I don't know where I'm gonna wear it. Maybe I'll rock this for Easter. Too much? I don't think so. I think it's cute. I love it. Okay, and last but not least is this beach cover-up dress, which is so pretty. I got it in black, and I put a little shorts and bralette underneath so you could kind of see what it looks like without putting a bathing suit on. But I feel like you could also wear it like this if you wanted to wear it to dinner. Just make sure you have, like, you know, full shorts that are covering everything. But I kind of like that see-through vibe. I feel like mesh is really in, and kind of those sheer fabrics, so it's just really pretty. Yeah. Okay, and one last item, because these are incredible, are these cream leather pants. They fit perfect. I'm pretty sure I ordered these in a size 4 before, and they were not the right fit for me, so I went down to a 2, and now they're literally just perfect. I have some shorts underneath, so if there's a little line, that's why. But the prettiest faux leather cream, I mean, look at that. They look super expensive. They feel really nice and just literally like this, like a bralette and some strappy sandals. They are stunning. So, wow, really chic and pretty. But yeah, okay, that's going to wrap it up for the misguided haul. I'll have everything linked down below, sizing and everything in case you forgot everything. You don't have to like rewind or anything. And we will hop right into the rest of the vlog right now. Play Peaches by Justin Bieber.
Bop time.
I got my peaches out in Georgia. Yeah, shit. I get my weed from California. That's that shit. I took my chick up to the north, yeah. Badass bitch. I get my light right from the source, yeah. Yeah, that's it. And I see you. Your skin. I wanna wrap my arms around you, baby, never let you go. And I see you. There's nothing like your touch. It's the way you lift me up. Yeah, and I'll be right here with you till the end.
I got my peaches out in Georgia.
Oh yeah, shit.
I get my weed from California.
That's that shit.
I took my chick up to the north, yeah.
Badass bitch.
I get my light right from the source, yeah. Yeah, that's it.
Man, I'm sore.
We're back, bitches.
I feel like I'm walking like a robot right now.
I know, I'm sore too. Really sore. I think it was these. Ow!
My abs are sore. Julia's like... Julia, you were like, I can't see my abs right now. I haven't seen them in a while.
Okay.
I see them. You got a little lines going though. But I was saying, I've been doing something, like I've been doing ab workouts every day.
Yeah.
And I feel my abs.
Mm-hmm. But we can't feel.
Can't see them. So I know they're there because I can feel them.
It's the tortillas.
But I ate too many tortillas.
That's okay. It's from the inside that counts, yeah. Not the outside.
Wow.
Somebody asked me on Instagram if I've seen a difference from F45. And I was kind of offended because I'm like, do I not look any different? Like, why did you have to ask me that? Then I guess you don't see it, so I guess no.
Maybe not new.
Just don't do it then. And I asked her, I was like, have you ever done F45? So I'm like, it's freaking hard. Like, but I don't like questions like that because it's like, well, are you doing it just because you want to look different? Like, you're not going to last very long if that's your only motivation to work out, in my opinion. You gotta work out for.
I would say F45.
To feel good and
F45
mental.
Changed their life.
I know. I think it did too. I think like, yeah, your diet is the most powerful thing. Which. Are you kidding me?
Damn it!
But you had to turn my off. That's what. Better doesn't turn off
the alarm. Good morning, Nashville. Top of the morning to you.
Should I shower?
No, you're the only person I know that showers before a workout.
Oh, okay. I bet. Does anyone y'all do that?
Are you?
Do any of y'all, what?
You have a booger on your shirt. That's disgusting.
You have them on your face sometimes.
Okay, down.
I don't have to tell you, you're like, this is just you, who cares? I'm like, fuck, I'm just telling you, just like you told me and you freaked out about it.
I know.
I just say, hey, you have that. You're like, oh my god, I can't. It's like, come on.
Alrighty, peeps, we're ready for the gym. This is the OOTD. Here, let's go this way, it's brighter.
We've got the set active
set, one shouldered. I think this color is no longer available. But I wear a small in the top, and then these are extra small, small bottoms, and I feel like they're really nice and snug. I could probably go up a size, but yeah, I'd probably go up a size, but then they wouldn't be like quite as snatched. No set active.
Those are cute.
Okay, this is my Click the Label sweatshirt. Is that a cute? And I'm just gonna leave it on like this right now. I've never worn a sweatshirt like this, but you know, I almost bought one that kind of looked like this, but now I see that they just wear it like that. That's pretty cool. Anyways, let's put it over. Okay, have to say, I just don't feel super chatty this morning.
I'm gonna pop my probiotic.
Well, April is our revive month.
It is.
I'm gonna tell you, we have some big plans for April, but tell you in a minute.
The 2nd of April.
Mm-hmm. Okay. I'm gonna do a little makeup for the gym. Huh? Maybe just a little bit. I've been doing my makeup in the kitchen.
In Texas, we were able to vlog more, and for some reason here, we've been busier than ever, where we haven't been able to vlog as much.
Well, we're also getting like settled into a new house. And
yeah.
Boy, you guys.
It just, but that alone feels like we're not on our game. And I just want to fill in my game again.
I know.
I'm ready to be batting a 300, you know?
Same, bro. I got on a little makeup for the gym. I usually like to do like a BB cream or CC cream. I just got in this e.l.f. camo CC cream. It's a lighter shade though, and I mixed it with the It Cosmetics CC cream in tan. I'm pretty sure this is a dupe for this, and it's really good. And ooh, it has niacinamide in it. Perfect. So I just mix those based on color, but I have so many different colors, but I don't know. I'm weird. I just wanted to mix them. So I'm liking that. I should have just done my Sephora collection, but sometimes the CCs give me a little bit more glow for the gym. This is really good for like kind of an all day wear because it's a little bit more of a matte finish, but sometimes I just want like a little glow for my workout, and then, but then this would be like kind of too oily for me to wear throughout the day, so that's why I like Sephora collection. Anyways, it's like a whole thing, but.
Can you have a split banana with me?
Sure. I'll have half a nanner. I still kind of look dead, but it's fine. Maybe some bronzer. Skin is a hot mess too.
Oh.
All right.
We gotta go.
I need a water. Here.
On the road again.
On the road again. Every morning. We're on the road.
Get the squirrels.
Squirrels, bro.
Squirrels are infuriating me.
So excited for our landscape. We're finally kind of met with a landscape person, and they are going to refresh our landscape because it is in shambles, basically.
We're getting new sod. We're gonna get new grass across the front.
Put my banana in my purse.
Perfect. Just something newer.
My sunglasses. Boo. Boo, woo, woo. Okay. I literally hate lifting weights. I hate it. I'm a cardio girl. I like cardio. I don't know what it is. I know a lot of people hate it, but I love it. Like, it gives me like that like adrenaline high, or adrenaline high, sorry. Like endorphin high. I love that. Like, kind of like a runner's high, but weights. When?
Wasn't that bad.
I don't like it. I hate lifting weights. So hard.
Put on hand sanitizer.
Yeah. You just wash your hands.
I know, I want some of that too. I mean.
Alright, arms are dead. Time to get at it today. Got a busy day ahead. Hunter's going to the dentist. And
I have a dentist appointment that's focused on my wisdom teeth.
Yeah.
I'm going to an oral surgeon to see if I potentially need to get my wisdom teeth out. They've been killing me for like a week.
Yeah. Is it still hurting?
Not as bad. They were hurting last night though. Mm-hmm. And I took some Advil before I went to sleep.
That's good. I've been waking up hungry, which is really weird.
I have too. But I think it's because we're going to bed earlier and we're eating earlier.
Really?
Okay. We've been going to bed. Check this.
Guys.
Where it says 9 is still on the clock. Like,
yeah, I mean,
it might be like 9:40 or 9:50.
We're making moves over here.
Sometimes 9:20.
Making moves.
But our goal is to get in bed before the clock strikes 10. So.
And we're winning at it.
We're crushing it.
Yeah.
Except last night, you got in bed like at 10:02.
I know.
You were like a little bit.
I wasn't quite ready. Well, because I had a crazy day, and I feel like I went back to back to back to like phone call to work to whatever, and I never got one moment to just like zen out and like wind down for me.
Yeah.
But this is how it feels when you're like a mom and you have kids. Like, you're just like, all you do is like you're worried about everyone else the whole day, and then you just get no time to like yourself.
You were worried about me yesterday.
It's like brutal.
I'll tell you that.
Yeah, but any time that I was like taking a break from work, you were like
ready to chat.
Yeah. And I'm like, I just like, you know, I got no points.
Yeah.
My friend Taylor taught me, she's a fellow introvert, taught me this term for introverts. She always says, like, you know, as an introvert, you only have a certain like amount of fuel in your like, you know, social tank.
You almost have like a certain amount of coins in your tank.
So she calls it, she says, I only got like, I wake up with 3 coins. And if I have no coins left, that means like, you know, you're tapped. You have to like be by yourself, stare at the wall. So, yeah, yesterday I had like no coins left, and I just was kept, I was going like negative in my account, you know?
Yeah, you're starting off like under today.
Yeah, a little bit. Well, I got like 1 coin in me right now.
But we did have a nice little coin conversation last night.
We did have a good coin.
It was, if you only have 4 coins and you normally.
This is a very sweet question.
What can we do in your life, in Julia's world,
Hunter said,
to make it where
what
she wakes up with 8 coins instead of 4? I want to double her coin amount.
He said, how can I add to the coin amount? What can I do to help preserve your coins and add more? I was like, that is such a sweet question.
Well, I'm being serious.
Well, it works for both of us.
Yeah, well,
happy wife,
more
happy
for
life.
Me, more for you. It's like, hey, if you have more coins, you have more time to chat.
More to give this one?
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. I know.
But it's a question that's what can I do to take things off your plate where you can preserve your coins longer and wake up the next day with maybe an additional coin each day?
That's really nice.
Add to the bank.
Ooh, you are sweaty. Ooh.
Trying to add to the bank of Juge.
Yeah.
The International Juge Bank.
That's really nice. Thank you so much.
That was a good workout though today. I liked today's.
Because
it was like slower paced kind of. And like you could focus on.
Yeah, I like when there's 3 sets because it kind of gives you time to perfect the exercise before you just.
I also like when it's like 3 sets of 35 seconds rather than like a minute, 30, and then 20.
I know.
Like I hate when it's like.
Yeah, I like the structure.
I hate the long minutes. Sets. You can't, there's certain workouts that you legitimately cannot do for a full minute.
No.
Well, look how perfectly that's mowed, the straight lines.
Perfect.
It's like a ballpark.
Who does your landscape?
Yeah. Do you want to get a protein shake?
Sure.
From Smoothie King? Or
yeah.
Do you want to go get juices somewhere? Or we could get acai bowls at Franklin Juice Co.
Let's do that. Those for lunch.
That sounds good. Let's do that right now.
For breakfast.
And we can get some protein powder added to it.
Okay, I'll order them.
Let's just stop.
But there, it's in full self.
Okay, let me go over.
Okay. Let's go. All right. We're in 12 South. And these are the best acai bowls at Franklin Juice Co. They've got great smoothies, juices, but their acai bowls hit different. And we've tried a few acai bowls, but I think these are definitely the best. Franklin Juice Co. So good.
Yummers.
Yeah, okay, I think I got the standard last time. Standard acai bowl.
Do you want a small or a large?
A small, please.
Small?
And then can I add peanut butter? And do you guys have protein powder you can put in the base? Okay.
Yeah, we can just blend it in the base.
Awesome.
So
it's not like and it's plant-based, cool. Yum, okay, I got the standard acai bowl. I get the small, the larges are pretty big, so I would recommend a small. And it comes with like strawberries, bananas, goji berries, and I add peanut butter. We got protein powder in it. And Hunter got pea pollen on his because, you know, allergy vibes.
Okay.
All right.
Straight ginger.
Do not get honey in your acai bowl. It's too sweet.
Especially if you get pollen. It's honey overload.
Yeah.
Okay. Straight ginger.
Straight ginger.
Ginger, cayenne, lemon.
I think ginger after all the sugar.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wait.
No, yeah. This isn't her face. After that, I'll see you both. Ooh, bitches. Spicy! Damn! Okay. It is about 6:30 now, and we've just had a busy day. This is the deal. Oh my gosh. Ever since we've moved to Nashville, every night, I'm like, okay, we get groceries every week, we're like, we're gonna cook, and every night when I'm done working, I'm like, I just literally wanna lay down. I mean, to the point where I'm like, I'd rather just not eat because I just like don't want to cook. Like that's how unmotivated I am to cook. It's really bad. So no surprise I'm feeling that way now. And I'd rather just lay down and watch some YouTube or relax or something. I don't know. I've just been so tired. Can't figure it out. Well, I'm not pregnant. I know that for certain. So yeah. I don't know what we're gonna do. Hunter's wrapping up work too. And then maybe he'll be up for cooking something. I'm gonna make a fire because it is so cold. Our weather is also like gone from, was beautiful one day, like 75, 80 degrees. And then now it dropped back down to 39. So it is super cold. And yeah, I did my makeup really fun today. It's kind of like shifting now, but I think I'm gonna do a little tutorial on it because a lot of you guys asked, so that was fun to actually like play around with some makeup. What's wrong with me? I've been sleeping like 9 hours a night. Anywho, yeah, I'm gonna make a fire and then I'm gonna watch some YouTube and we'll come up with a dinner plan. There we go. Let's see who shall we watch. Oh, my camera's gonna die. Okay, I will be back when we have a dinner plan and we're gonna cook or something. We will see.
I just fixed Julia's fire a little bit ago. Looking much better than what she had it as. And I'm about to cook some dinner. So, Julia, are you cool with steak in like a salad?
Yeah.
What, will you help me make a dressing in a little bit?
Yeah.
Okay.
Do you want me to make a Caesar?
That sounds good.
Okay, I'll do that.
Do we have all the stuff? We have anchovies.
Yeah.
We've got lemon. I bought garlic.
Yeah, we should have everything.
Okay.
Do you want to leave me them?
To what?
The
to what?
For the croutons.
I know. To what?
Oh, 400.
All right, I bought two meats. I bought a boneless New York strip that's dry aged. And I bought a bone-in beef ribeye steak. And I figured, let's just do, I only bought like one of each, and this one's not very big. This one, we don't have to eat it all, we can save leftovers. But why not do like a little tasting sampler and try them side by side and see which one I like better. Here they are side by side. There's the New York strip. It's dry aged for 30 days. And then this is the bone-in ribeye. All right, the best way to cook a steak, sometimes even better than grilling it, is to broil it. And for the last minute or two, cook it on high heat on a pan, like 1 minute on each side. So the only ingredients you need, salt and pepper. And then once it's ready, you serve with like a little bit of parsley. That's like my favorite way to cook steak. So I've done it on the Traeger before. Even when I cook a steak on the Traeger or any other grill, I'll bring it in for the final like minute on each side and just like char it on each side just to give it like a crisp outside. So I'm gonna do salt and push the salt into the steak. Like even salt the sides. Do the same thing with the pepper. And put more pepper than you think you actually need. So the steaks are good to go. And when you broil it,
do it for about 12 to 14 minutes, depending on your broiler, I think, but flip it halfway. So when I do it, I normally do 12 minutes and flip it halfway through, so 6 minutes on each side in the broiler, then bring it out and instantly throw it on the hot pan. If you have a cast iron skillet, that probably works best. Get it really hot and just do a minute on each side. Boom, boom, take it off, let it sit for like 10 minutes, and then chop her up. Sprinkle with some parsley, good to go. I'm going to chop my parsley, get that ready to go. Okay, they're wrapping up on their final side, like a couple more minutes. Alright, so 1 minute on each side. So that's even more cooked than I initially wanted, but that's perfect. That's probably medium rare, I guess. We're going for medium rare / rare. But it is what it is.
Okay, here we go. I made my Caesar against my will. I did not want to.
You don't want to make it?
Well, I'm just, my motivation is really low. I know it is my idea because I'm trying to force myself.
And that's the bone-in ribeye.
Mm-hmm.
And this is the dry-aged New York strip.
Yum.
We had little samples of both as like I was cutting them up, but
yeah,
I think we're liking this better. Yeah. The dry-aged New York strip.
Both really good. And then we've got our wine, so we'll see. We're going to eat in private, but this is like a steak.
Still got a little bit of water to finish off.
This is like a steakhouse dinner.
It is.
Mm-hmm. Okay, goodbye.
Okay, so we've got the Truly multi-pack.
Yeah, and it comes with watermelon, which we had today.
It's like their summer pack, like lemonades. It's all lemonades.
So we have three flavors here. We've got mango lemonade, original lemonade, and strawberry lemonade.
Yeah.
And a little bit ago we had the watermelon lemonade, which is their newest flavor. It's watermelon lemonade, and it was good.
Yeah.
It's just like, it honestly tastes like watermelon flavor. Yeah. So
we're curious though if we're gonna like these flavors better. So we're like, let's try them. I'm gonna start with basic lemonade because I just wanna know what the simple, the base order tastes like. Okay.
Go ahead.
Nice. Simple, lemon.
Nice.
Very like.
Exactly what I expected.
Yeah, okay. I like it.
Mango or strawberry next?
I don't think I'm gonna like the mango, so I'm gonna go for strawberry. That's good. It's sweet, but it's good. What's the alcohol in these, actually?
I think they're vodka. I think it's vodka.
It's vodka?
It's good. That's good. I feel like it could be stronger. I like those better than original.
You do?
No, this
that could
is,
be your mixer or your chaser.
This is tied with watermelon as my favorite. These two over. I didn't really like original.
Oh, look. Original's good. It's a good base.
Okay, mango.
Okay, mango.
Smells good.
It does, actually. Mm-hmm. Okay.
That's nice.
It
you'll,
is?
You'll like that.
Really? That is nice.
Yeah.
Okay, mango's delicious.
That is really good.
This is tied with watermelon. I actually like all of them. They're different. The lemon is like, just if you want a simple lemon.
That's my least
favorite. Let me try it again.
It's just not doing it for me. I would personally rather have just a lemonade.
Yeah, well, yeah. You can mix this with a tea.
Mm-hmm. That would be good.
Mm-hmm. I don't know, Palmer. Spike. That would be really good.
What's a spiked Arnold?
They're
Palmer?
All delicious.
Oh, that's called
honestly.
A John Daly.
What is?
A spiked Arnold Palmer.
It is?
Yeah.
Who's John Bailey?
John Daly. It's another
Daisy,
golfer.
No. Who's John Bailey?
Mango's nice. strawberry is nice.
And if you wanna...
The mango is all the way.
Watermelon.
Let's
sugar.
Try the watermelon.
Hi.
Okay. Let's try the watermelon again. Now I need to compare.
I love watermelon. Like if I go for a Jolly Rancher, it's watermelon.
It literally smells like Jolly Rancher.
I think
Rancher.
That's why I like it. My favorite flavor. JR. Tastes like it, right?
Yeah. It tastes like a watermelon Jolly Rancher.
But your favorite Jolly Rancher isn't watermelon.
I do like watermelon. I like cherry.
The lead?
Mango, watermelon,
stunning. Strawberry, and then the OG.
They're all beautiful though. So if you just get the pack, it's a good time. They're all good. I wouldn't be disappointed if I had any of them.
Right.
You know, based on whatever's
available. But now that I've tried, if someone's like, hey, you want a Truly, and they toss me this one, I would know that I like other flavors better.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what I mean?
For you, the
one. But this one, I mean, it's good. It's not like I don't like it. I just like the flavored better.
Yeah.
Get a pack of Truly. Do a test and let us know which one is your favorite.
Yeah, tell us your favorite.
A lot of y'all probably have already tried them all.
Are you guys
except
Truly,
probably this one.
Truly
since
fans?
It's new.
I wonder what their other, like, non super flavors are.
Should we pound these into a Spritz and Chips?
Oh my god.
It would be kind of funny. What time is it? 8:30. Mm-hmm. We basically have like an hour and 20
evening.
Minutes before we have to be in bed.
I know. You would have this new bedtime. It's like 10 p.m.
I think we talked about earlier.
Oh.
We're in bed before the clock strikes 10.
We are.
Doesn't matter. You can get in bed at 9:05. You can get in bed at 9:55, 58, 59. Just before. Like lights out before 10.
I know. You've been wearing the sunglasses for like a couple hours, huh?
Oh, I haven't taken them off. It appears that when I take them off, they get lost.
It does appear that way. Did you call the dentist's office?
I did. They were closed.
We think Connor left us.
I think I left my
Did you update them on your wisdom teeth? Show them your charts. Get
my
your charts.
I don't know where they are.
Get your charts.
My charts. I got my x-rays done on my wisdom teeth.
Get your charts.
You go get my charts.
You need the diagram to
no,
see the whole
thing.
No,
you can't
because
they scribbled all over them and you can't even really see it. All
right.
So, the tooth that's hurting me.
I think it's
my wisdom tooth down here that's hurting me. It's grown in. It's pretty much grown in all the way. And
Hunter's been having some issues with his wisdom tooth. Did
yes.
we explain that?
I think so.
Maybe.
So, I've had wisdom teeth problems. We both kind of do. Every once in a while, they both hurt. Should you go get yours checked out too?
I will after you do it.
Why? We should just do it together.
I'm avoiding the doctor.
It'd be so funny if we did a video.
I don't want to do it together. We need somebody. We need one needs to be able to
a
take care of the other.
Yeah.
Caretaker. One of my flaws I notice about myself is that I feel like shy to ask people when I need something.
You don't want to be.
I don't want to.
You don't want to rely on somebody.
No. Well, it's not that I don't want to rely on them, but I feel like if I ask someone for something or if I present my feelings, like if I'm upset or if I'm feeling in a place, like it's a burden. And I feel that like with everybody. So I just suppress it until like you're literally probably the only person I ever express that to.
Yeah.
And it's to when I have like a breaking point, I'm like, I can't hold it anymore.
But I think it's common when you're married to suppress your feelings except to like a really close friend.
Yeah.
Or
yeah.
your spouse. Or like your spouse or a really close friend.
I agree. Yeah. But like, for instance, you are much more vocal about your thoughts and you're not as like, you'll express them easily to people or to me and you
maybe
don't
I'm,
feel.
Maybe I'm more self-centered.
No, it's not in that way. Like you're like more confident. Like you don't, like the person's reaction doesn't mean anything to you. You're like, oh, I'm just like throwing it out there. But if you're not like gonna listen or whatever, like it doesn't have any effect on me. But
that's
if
annoying.
I,
that's annoying.
It's not annoying.
Let me just talk about how sick I've been. I'm gonna talk about my wisdom teeth. And if you don't want to listen, I don't care. I'm gonna keep talking.
No, but
that's annoying.
No, but that's cool. Like you literally like could say anything to anyone, and you don't care if they like it or not. You're like, well, it doesn't matter to me if you like it. But I, if somebody turns me down, if I express how
maybe,
I feel,
maybe you're a little more calculated in that way.
I think I am like seeking
or like the approval.
Seek approval. Why though?
But then there's so many other instances where, like, I don't give a shit what anyone mm-hmm. thinks about things. So why is it that I think that? I don't know.
I do not know the answers to that.
It's okay.
But it's a work in progress.
I know.
And you're fine.
I know.
I think you're like, she's trying to connect dots again. She's always trying to connect dots. She was trying to connect dots earlier today that were just like, you know those, like, connect dot, drawings? You're basically, like, connecting dots from, like, one drawing and trying to, like, connect them to another drawing. And it's like, they're two separate drawings. They don't go together. Mm. Quit trying to connect dots.
But just, like, your brain just, like, to turn off? Like, you don't, like, think about that stuff?
Maybe I talk about it. So it's, like, just, like, I've talked about it and I move on. I don't know. Talk about what stuff, though? Like, what emotion should I be feeling?
I don't know. Right, I feel like everything I'm thinking, like, why did that happen? Or what is this? Or whatever. And you just, like, are like, oh, you're just, like, it's, like, nothing to think about. Like, don't even think about that. And I'm like, oh, really?
Well, it's not like I just, like, am so loose and let things go. Like, I try to get down to the bottom of things myself.
I know. But there's certain things that tick you that don't tick me and vice versa.
Well, everybody's different.
Right.
And you're doing just fine.
Mm-hmm.
I think you stress yourself out. I think that's a common thing these days. People stress themselves out.
Yeah.
And you put a lot on your plate. And sometimes it's stuff that, like, shouldn't be on your plate. Like, let dessert come later. Dessert doesn't have to be with, like, your lunch and dinner at the same time on the same plate.
Okay.
Let dessert come later.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
Kind of.
Like, don't be stressing about something that is happening tomorrow, here at the house, doing something when you're wanting to work on work.
Okay.
Like, do one thing at a time.
Yeah, I know. It's hard for me.
Eat one bite at a time.
I think that's what's been really hard, like, being here, is that I want the house to be done. All I want to do is, like, focus on the house.
I know.
That's all I want to do.
That's, I know. But in my free time, I do focus on that. You focus on it in your not free time. You're, like, trying to, like, answer an email while you're, like, scrolling through Pinterest at the same time looking at stuff. Or, like, answer an email while you're responding on text to someone about a chair. Or, like, you're doing it all too much at the same time. Like, space it out one thing at a time.
I know, I just, like, can't. It's hard to, like, shut off.
And I think since we moved here, we haven't been as organized with work.
Yeah.
And so our work's been all over the place. Even you and I, like, on a connection level, like, we haven't been as, like, eye to eye with work.
Yeah.
When we always have been for the past 3.5-4 years.
Yeah. No, I know. I think we felt, like, a little bit scattered. Just kind of, like, there's so much going on.
I think there's so much going on since we got here.
It's distracting.
That we
It's hard to find, like, one thing to, zone in.
We're, like, in survival mode to get things done,
mm-hmm.
but in that sense, like, we're doing less because we're not as efficient because we're not as organized.
Agree. So well, you know what?
Get organized. It's important to be organized because you can't be efficient.
I made a daily schedule the other day, and I time blocked myself. There was, like, probably, like, 12 tasks on there, and I hit all of them, and I time blocked it, and it was like bam, 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 and it was awesome. But you have, that's, like, the only way to do it. So I ordered these daily planners on Amazon. You might like, you're not so much of a daily organizer. You're kind of,
I saw, like, those on your Instagram.
They're so good, though. And, like, it's, like, time, like, by the hour. And it's, like, priorities. So, like, you know, when you have so much to do, you're like, I have so much to do. But it's like, okay, well, what three things actually have to be done today?
Right.
What can I push to tomorrow? A lot,
I
usually.
Wonder if Noah, having him around, brought us to, like, Earth.
Yeah.
Like, when we're busy doing something, he brought us, like, let us step away from work for a second and, like, hey, this is real life. And then we took care of, like, another task outside.
Do you
of
think
work.
He, like, created some structure for us?
No, not structure. I mean, no, I don't think so.
Do you know what was weird when the fire alarm went off tonight? I was like, that's the first time the fire alarm has ever gone off. We didn't have a dog because my first instinct is, like, the dog, because their ears.
Mm-hmm.
And I always worried about Goose. When the fire alarm would go off when we were cooking, because he would, like, start to cry or freak out, and then I was like, it's just us. Like, we don't have to even think about it.
I thought about him tonight.
Yeah.
When I was making the steak and I cut the bone off the bone in ribeye. And I was like, I'd normally let my goose like sniff it or like eat some of the pieces off of it.
Yeah. Sweet baby.
He seems like a distant memory.
I know. Way. Well, the further and further it goes on, like, it just, like, yeah, drifts away kind of into the distance.
He was like one of our dogs.
Mm-hmm. Well, we've only had one, so.
No, I mean, I'm like, in 20 years from now, we'll look back and be like, he was like our first of many.
Yeah.
You know? Well, it'll be sad.
I know. I haven't gotten sad enough by him, but I think I'm just like, it's overwhelmed.
I saw a picture on Instagram today. I guess it was like one of our followers or one of you guys posted. And it was from our YouTube video of when someone sent us flowers and we like lifted the goose up and he like sniffed the rose.
Mm-hmm.
And they screenshot that and like it was one of their Instagram pictures.
That's sweet.
It's weird though to think how many dogs are like on the planet and he was just one, like one personality.
I know.
Like.
And like everyone is obsessed with their dog just as much.
I know. I just feel like you don't see too many people our age going through that.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
Well, because they're usually like getting a dog or...
I know.
That's weird to think that we've had him like when we first met and then...
We got him like a year after knowing each other, kind of. Right?
Yeah.
Right around that time?
Yeah.
We met in August.
What made you want to get a dog then?
I don't know. It's funny, we met in August. Met on August 30th. 31st. No, August 30th. And then yeah. Noah was born August 28th the following year.
Where?
Then we got him like 6 weeks after that. Or 8 weeks or whatever. I don't know how when you get a puppy.
Puppy. He's so cute. Oh my god.
Look up there on the mantle.
Shut up.
My sunglasses are there. And you know what? I took them off when I was cleaning out the fireplace.
Oh my god. Because they're on your shirt and they're probably dangling over and you're trying to scoop up the thing. Speaking of, should we go get more logs?
Golly, they're right there.
They're right there. We're looking everywhere for them, you guys.
For a freaking Instagram picture.
Well, these are the other pairs. That's good.
These are good. I haven't really worn these yet. I don't feel like it's been the right setting for me to wear these yet.
Mm-hmm. They're pretty cute.
I feel like they're so summer, like beach.
They're definitely like, you gotta be in Florida or something.
Right.
Yeah.
And I feel like I gotta have my hair down too.
They're cute though.
I just like never liked the way I looked in glasses.
Really?
Ever. With sunglasses. It's like, it's...
You've never told me that.
I've said it before on the vlog. It's always hard for me. It's always been hard for me to find glasses that, like, I really like it, the way they fit my face.
Yeah. Well, I would say that that's maybe a valid thing for guys in general. Because it's not like...
I think sunglasses can make dudes look like tools.
100%. Yeah.
Sorry.
Definitely.
Yeah.
They're like, most of them are like dorky.
Glasses?
Yeah.
No.
This is a ping pong ball.
Really?
Yeah, I literally... Where is that? From the dentist's office?
Yeah.
Oh.
Try it.
Okay.
I tried to give you some earlier.
I know, I had lipstick on. Here, try these on.
No, I've already done this. They're
too,
like, long and skinny.
They are. Oh, yeah. Actually, they're kind of cute.
Too small for me.
If you're in Europe, for sure. For sure.
Maybe in Europe, yeah. It's good, right?
This is from your dentist's office.
Yeah, it's take one for free.
Does this not look like a ping pong ball? I thought it was a ping pong ball. It's a lip balm. Mmm. Coconut?
It's good, right?
Yeah. Great.
It's a good, like, the it's soft.
These are cute on me. Well, so, what?
These are cute on me.
They are. They're Amazon. $10. Maybe not even $10.
Love a good deal.
Love a good deal. Love a good deal. Love a good designer.
I'm digging these.
You're digging the Trulies? Okay. I'm taking my wine. We're gonna go get some more logs.
I truly am. Are you gonna put shoes on?
You truly are. Good one. No, I'm not gonna put on any shoes. our fire is pretty much out of logs. There's a one. So we're gonna go out to our stack. We'll show you guys where we keep our wood. We got a pallet of wood delivered.
It's called a rick of
oh,
wood.
It's called a rick of wood, okay.
Mm-hmm. Rick with an R.
Here's Olivier. Ooh, it actually it feels a little bit warmer than it did earlier. What? Hunter! Oh my god. It scared me. Oh, you can't really see. Do you have a flashlight? Oh, perfect. Here's our rick.
So the rick was like this tall.
Yeah.
But anyway.
So, we hold that as how well. Many logs are we going to get? It's been kind of chilly, so.
Start with one in the hand.
Uh huh. You stack that hoe. There you go. Okay, now we go back in. Who used to chatter their teeth? Goosey did. Goose would chatter his teeth when he would get cold. It was so cute. It was so super cute.
Don't spill your water. I'm gonna tell you one. Cheers to a productive day. We got a lot done.
And cheers to a great April.
Cheers to the April.
Getting
April started right.
A lot of hope in April.
I know. Oh, so my wisdom teeth. I have to get two of them out for sure. I have the option to get the third out, like probably 40% need to get that one out, and then 10% need to get the other one out. It's an option. So I'm gonna do probably three of my teeth.
Yeah.
And I'm gonna be sedated, I'm gonna go down, and then I'll be out for like 3 days. Big old puppy face. We should do a video when I'm like turned
up.
For
sure, and then vice versa.
Yeah, because Julia has to get hers out too, so.
I would be so embarrassed.
When you're swollen?
Yeah. Well, I don't really care.
Well, cheers to April.
Yeah.
Let's have a good April, everybody. We're really excited for April. We have a lot of fun stuff planned for ourselves as well as for the YouTube channel, for all you guys.
Mm-hmm.
And so, let's make the best of it.
We have, like, so many ideas that we've had for, like, years almost that we've never been able to do. Or we just haven't done.
And I'm freaking burning.
We're burning.
Oh, my God.
This is like a guy versus a girl, right?
Oh, my shoe
is so hot. Yeah, hot. So yeah, we have some fun stuff coming.
Alright, love you guys. See you in a couple days. We'll probably have a spritz and chips coming soon.
We're vlogging a lot in April.
And then some more vlogs. So
yeah.
We know the past few weeks, I guess we did vlog week.
Yeah.
But really, even including vlog week, those vlogs, the number of vlogs we've released since the beginning of the year is pretty poor.
Yeah, it's been a little slow.
It's time to step it up.
We had a lot of transition, you guys. We had a lot to do, so we just need a little minute. We're gonna get back into it.
Cheers. Good night.
Cheers. Love you.